Hello everyone, I'm Siri. Today we're painting portraits inspired by the feature exhibition Art, Life, Legacy, Northern European Paintings in the collection of Isabel and Alfred Bader. We'll learn about the role of light in creating drama and emotion. Let's take a look at two paintings painted by Dutch painters in the 17th century. This portrait was painted by Jan Leivens. In this profile view, we only see half of the subject's face. Notice the way light shimmers on the fabric draping over her head. It creates highlights and glimmers on her jewelry. The back of her head is cast in a dramatic shadow. This contrast makes the light area seem even brighter. What mood does the light and shadow create? This portrait was painted by Rembrandt. The light draws our eyes to the face of the old man. Look at the dramatic forehead. We see deep wrinkles in his furrowed brow. His eyes gaze downward. Most of the detail in this painting is on the left side of the face. The background is simple, and his coat and cap appear as flat, dark shapes with only a few quiet details. What emotion do you think this portrait creates? Now, let's paint our own portraits. I'm going to paint a portrait that is realistic, or at the end, it'll look like me. Think about the pose of the head, the gaze of the eyes, and your light source. What kind of emotion would you like to create? I'm using acrylic paint, a palette, canvas board, water, paper towel, and a variety of brushes. First, I use a pencil to sketch my portrait. You can draw from life or look at a photo. Sketch big to small. Start with the overall shape of your head, then place the facial features within it. Your eyes are about halfway between the top of your head and your chin. I like using vertical and horizontal lines to help me measure the distances between my eyes, nose, and mouth. After I sketch my head, I'm going to quick fill it in a dark background, like the portraits we looked at. I mix together red, yellow, green, and white to match my light skin tone. Why green? Since green is complementary to red, it will dull the red in my mixture and make my skin tone less saturated or intense. If your skin tone is lighter or darker than mine, try beginning with mixtures of more white and yellow or purple and browns. Mix a lot of your skin tone. We'll adjust it to create highlights and shadows on the portrait. It might take a couple tries to get it close. I paint a watery skin tone wash over the entire face. I can see my pencil sketch below. I mix warmer and cooler tones on my palette. I add shadows with dark cool tones around my eyes, nose, chin, jawline, and side of my face. I add light with bright warm tones on my nose, brow, chin, and cheeks. In the paintings we looked at, the most detailed areas were in the path of light hitting the face. The rest of the shadowed clothing, hair, and background had fewer details. I mix a brown color for my hair and paint a flat shape. I pick out a few hairs to highlight around my face in the path of light. I do the same for my shoulders and clothes. Finally, I touch up my background. I hope you enjoy making your own portraits at home or here at the museum. Bye!